an array of enticing short films. The festival offers plenty of filmmaker appearances and such events as the festival panel discussion, How to Get a Movie Made, the Black Harvest Sneak Preview Party featuring Lottery Ticket, and closing night movie, Night Catches Us. Purchase a festival pass and see six movies for the price of five. That's Black Harvest, only at the Gene Siskel Film Center, located at 164 North State Street. For more information, call 312-846-2600 or SiskelFilmCenter.org.
There's a special comfort to feeling at home, feeling that people know you and care about you. The Southside Healthcare Collaborative believes that feeling at home should extend to your health. That's why a network of health centers and hospitals are working in your neighborhood to find you a medical home, a place where you have your own doctor, one who knows you and cares for your health, one who will be there for the long term. To find a medical home near you, call 773-702-5668.
Africa Unite. We hope in Africa Unite. And that's what we're doing on this show today. Welcome back, everyone. This is African Diaspora Today. I am your guest host, Russell Norman, filling in for the beautiful and brilliant Dr. Carol Adams, president of Dusable Museum. Yes, today we are talking about black youth. I want to encourage callers to call in at 773-591-1690. We are streaming live on WVON.com, and today we have some special guests. We're talking to our youth today. We have 14 years old Maurice Gilchrist. How you doing, sir?
Good.
And he's from the Rosa neighborhood. We have 22-year-old Megan Milton from the Princeton Park neighborhood. How you doing, miss?
I'm good.
All right, and we have Jasmine Howe from the Inglewood neighborhood. Hello there.
Hi.
Today, with my associate producer, Lori, we're going to talk about the perspective from the youth, from their own words. We're going to get it from the horse's mouth. And we're going to talk about how these kids deal with intimidation and going to school on a daily basis when they know their friends are getting murdered, to put it bluntly. The police presence is like off the chain. I know some kids, instead of feeling the presence of safety, I'm sure they're fearful of all of the police presence as well as the gang presence. Maurice, how do you deal with just going to school? Are you going to be a freshman at Finger this year?
No, I'm going to eighth grade.
You're going to eighth grade. Okay, so do you still see this in eighth grade? Do you know kids who brought guns to school and you're in grammar school?
Yeah, I know a lot of kids that brought guns to school.
Wow, you say that so nonchalantly. You know that's really very detrimental and it's very horrific.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Okay, so tell us, how do you feel about that with, you know, the youth? Because where I'm from, the kids your age should never have to deal with that. So how do you feel about that? Like, are you desensitized to it? Is it just every day?
It's an everyday thing. I'm used to it since I was born and raised around it, so it's an everyday thing for me.
Do you think there's a solution? I mean, you being the one on the front lines, do you think you see anything that can reach the youth?
Just, don't know. I'm with KLB, so I stayed with her all day. I got a mentor, Gerald.
Gerald who?
Gerald Spratton.
Could you say that one more time?
Gerald Spratton.
And that's your mentor on yes. Kids Off the Block?
Yes.
And what does he help you with?
He helped me with a lot of things. I'll be with him every day almost. He a little rapper, you know okay. what I'm saying? I'll be with him. And this dude named Butter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and I'll be with him. Okay. Sometimes I spend that over his house every day.
I think we all know Butter, or a Butter. So, Jasmine, I wanted to ask you and Megan, you dealing with you graduating high school, of course, ladies, and now that you're probably in college or at that age, what do you see in your 20s? Do you see, like, the youth desensitized, not caring, ignorant about the things that's going on?
It's just really a struggle that we as the youth have to go through it. And it's to the point where our youth has given up on themselves. Mm. And instead of them choosing life, they choose wrong. And it's to the point where everyone is just giving up. And, you know, it's really messed up. It is.
Right. So, Megan, how do you feel about this? So, tell us about some of your experiences in the neighborhood and in Princeton Park, of all places.
I mean, I was fortunate enough to, like, I was brought up in that kind of neighborhood, but I always had the opportunity to, like, excel. I went to, like, a private high school, you know. I went to a good college, you know what I'm saying?
What college is that?
I was at Columbia. Right now I'm at the Illinois Center for Broadcasting.
Great.
Trying to be where you are, you know, okay. right now. But I think, like, something like that's the relevant as far as in my age group and my category is, yes, we do go to college and we venture off to different things, but sometimes we fall back into those neighborhoods and we go home and we get ourselves in so many different, you know, wrapped around so many different things because you have these different ties, like, oh, that's my friend from grade school, or this is mm-hmm. that, so you end up in that unfortunate situation.
Yeah, peer pressure is a big problem that we're facing. Maurice, do you deal with peer pressure on a daily basis?
Yeah, all the time.
Tell us a story or something that you've dealt with when somebody maybe tried to coerce you into something or something you dealt with going to school.
Somebody tried to give me the smoke with them, and I ain't never tried to. So, because I play football a lot, so.
Okay, you're an athlete, yeah. So you already know no smoking, no drinking, so. Okay, so we know that. So tell us, what did you say from someone who's 14? What did you say to someone who, did they try to get you to smoke some weed?
I told them they should not smoke. That's bad for them. That's bad for their health. So they should not smoke.
Hey, there you go. Now, we don't hear that a lot, do we? Usually we hear, okay, yeah. Where we going to smoke
yeah,
at?
We don't hear that.
So tell us about some specific problems that you've dealt with.
Well, coming from the Princeton Park area, you know, it's just, you know, guys pulling you over, harassing you. It's just too much that you have to deal with as far as being young. You got all these teen pregnancies. It's like that's the new accessory now, baby.
It's a trend.
Right.
It's in our music as well. It's what we're listening to. It's hypnotizing our minds to want to go out and do wrong. Gucci Mane and Waka Flocka go say, oh, they want to smoke weed all day and they want to go shoot this person and shoot right. this person's mother up. So our youth go out there and they say, well, you know what? We want to do the same thing they doing.
But it's not just about the entertainers because it's a such thing as performing, you know? Mm-hmm. So it's not just the entertainers. It's becoming a product of your environment and just seeing it every day. You could talk to little boys and ask them what they want to be when they grow up and they say, I want to be a gangster. Right. You know what I'm saying? Because they see the drugs, they see the traffic, they see the police, they see all of that every day, so they decide to be a product of that environment. Like, you know, they don't just see it on TV.
You know what, I agree, but I think that people see some of these entertainers and they're making millions of dollars and no one's holding them accountable for these negative images that they're disseminating to our youth, and then the direct result is what we see on the streets. If I see another person, you know, with they boxes or they drawers showing, sagging their pants, looking like a fool with your pants on the ground. You know, if I see another girl walking to the corner store in her pajamas, man, people just rolling out of bed and they just on the streets looking like zombies, walking around looking crazy. And our youth, our beautiful black youth, beautiful black young men and beautiful black young women, we can hold ourselves up with class, something better than what they trying to give us. They trying to shovel it down our throat.